الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى أما بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل اللهم مالك الملك تؤتي الملك من تشاء وتنزع الملك ممن تشاء وتعز من تشاء وتذل من تشاء بيدك الخير إنك على كل شيء قدير وقال سبحانه وتعالى في مقام آخر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم There was a time when there was nothing but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at one point of time, if you want to talk about relative terms, He thought of creating the heavens and the earth and the human beings and all what's in the heavens and the earth. So that he be known, so that people can recognize him, so that people can praise him, so that people can worship him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ That I have not created men and jinn except that they worship me. That was the purpose of creation. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after creating everything that He created, He put all of us in a test. And that test is the test of iman, the test of belief, the test of certainty, the test of yaqeen. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, before sending all of us in this dunya, He subhanahu wa ta'ala, took an oath from all of us. He gathered, He created all the souls, all the arwah, and He asked all of us that who is your Lord? In fact, He asked Him a question, am I not your Lord? And everybody, of course, they were in the presence of their Lord, everybody said, Bala, yes indeed, you are our Lord. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He sent everybody in His or her appointed time in this dunya to test that oath that He took at one point, that who actually kind of fulfills that oath, who actually believe or remember what was told to him or what he actually said from and before his before him being sent into this world. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to test everybody. He wants to test all of us. So this test, this hour being sent into this dunya is the test of just that. That who believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it's a very short life. People come, people go, right? It's just like a tunnel in a big journey. So we have started from point A and we are going to point B. And during that journey, it's just like a small tunnel. It's a very small tunnel, by the way. In the bigger frame, it's like it's a very small thing, relatively speaking. And as soon as a child is born into this dunya, this is the first thing that's reminded to him. First thing that's reminded to him is that, you know, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Ila akhir al-adhan. He's reminded, you know, remember, the purpose for you being in this world is that Allahu Akbar. Allah is the greatest. This is what you have to remember when you are going to live in this small period of time. And then in the other ear, the aqama is said, qad qamat as-salah, qad qamat as-salah. With the addition of that, you know, don't forget that very soon the prayer will be said as well for you. And in fact, if people who study fiqh, the ideal case when the aqama is called, the ideal case is that as soon as the muazzin or the person who is saying the aqama, as soon as he says qad qamat as-salah, qad qamat as-salah, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah, the imam, he should right away say Allahu Akbar and start the prayer. And some muftis, they say that if there is a gap between the aqama and the prayer, then the person who is saying the aqama should redo the aqama. So the point is that there is not a lot of time between the aqama and the prayer. And this is exactly what's being told to that person, the human being who is coming in this dunya. Then you know, I'm saying adhan to remind you of the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you are here. Remember that oath that you took. And the other ear is said, okay, this is your aqama, and there won't be much time before the prayer will be offered very soon for you. And the problem is that people then tend to forget all of this. This is the problem. Then, and this is the test. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the way He created this universe is that He has put some physical laws in this dunya, right? For example, if that's what Newton did, right? He said that if an apple is fallen from a tree, it comes towards the ground, and that, he said, is a gravitational law. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, similarly, He has created some physical laws. And in terms of Sharia, they are called the Sunnatullah. These are the sunnahs of Allah. These are the habits of Allah. Right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَن تَجِدَ لِسُنَّةِ اللَّهِ تَبْدِيلًا. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala normally doesn't change his sunnah. But it's normally. And the test is that you are living in this world, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put some sunnahs out there, some physical laws, quote unquote. So what do you believe in? Do you believe in these physical laws or the sunnahs of Allah, as we call it as believers? Or do you look into something that's greater than that? What do you look at? This is our test for all the believers who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And almost everybody has forgotten that. Even the people who say we believe, when there is Allah, and then they keep on saying that we believe and we believe and we believe, but when that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sometimes sent some special tests, there's a general test, right? All our life is a test. The time that we are born and the time until the time that we die. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that, do you say that I believe and you will not be tested? And He says, I have tested everybody before you so that I can know that who is actually true in saying what he's saying is actually is just that's just tongue talking, and this not in the heart. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sometimes sends some special tests to people so that all the talk that they have been saying through their tongue, to check if it's really in their heart as well. Right? And this is all what life is about. That's it. This is all what life is about. We all are busy in like finding our jobs and, you know, working on our homes and decorating it and cooking and eating and going out and enjoying and this and that and playing football and cricket and etc., sitting in front of our TV screens and like browsing internet all the time. People are busy in all of this. That the stock market goes down, people get heart attacks because they've invested a lot in that and this. This is all that people are busy in. This is not what life is about. Life is something far greater than that. The purpose, the aim of life is far more than that. And this is what everybody has forgotten. And the reason that we sit here is just to remind each other, reminding my own self and to everybody, is just that, so that we don't forget. Why are we here? Where are we going? فَأَيْنَ تَتْهَبُونَ Where are then you going? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks this question. You get busy in all of this. فَأَيْنَ تَتْهَبُونَ Where are you going? مَا غَرَّكَ بِرَبِّكَ الْكَرِيمِ What has deluded you from your generous Lord? You're busy in all of this, what you're busy in. What has deluded you from your generous Lord? You were supposed to do something else. You are doing something else. Right? So the sunnahs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the physical laws, quote unquote, there is just that, like, for example, somebody builds a factory, right? And he says, you know, these are the processes that everybody has to go through. Process A, B, C, D, and F until there is a product that comes out. So this is normally the process, right? But people who work in, say, for example, in big organizations where there are processes that are followed, I mean, sure that we have to follow the processes, but these are the processes, right? But come on, forward. Come forward. So these are the processes, but I mean, where is it written that these processes cannot be changed? Right? Everything can be changed, and we know that it does change. When somebody feels, you know, that people who are project managers, they know that there's a deadline to deliver a project, but sometimes the customer comes back, you know, I actually need it far earlier than that because I am also my commitments, right? So some processes are bypassed and you know you have to deliver earlier. This is exactly what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does sometimes. There are processes that are set, but then sometimes it's not that Allah will not change it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does change it sometimes to show people, you know, and that's a big mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by the way, that He does that. It's a big mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He does that so that we be reminded, we can be reminded, you know, there was that we are looking at just the processes. We have to actually get to know about who has created these processes. It's a big mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but then the people are still sleeping. When people still keep sleeping, that's the problem. Because till they feel, they close their eyes, you know, as when a cat comes to pounce at a pigeon, right? What does a pigeon do? It closes its eyes. I mean, does the danger go away when it closes its eyes? No. Danger is there. And that's what people do. Sleep, close their eyes. Oh, ignore that. Oh, tsunami came, just ignore that. This earthquakes came, ignore that. Floods came, ignore that. You know, people had all these plans to go in for their vacation and their holiday period, this, that, and that. And they went to the airport, they had all these plans in their mind. Suddenly there's a lot of snowfall. All this air traffic is jammed. Nobody can go. They're on the airport, at the airport 72 hours. They couldn't make it. People close their eyes. Oh, you know. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows that, you know, you make all these plannings, you do all of these plannings, but there is somebody else who is making the planning. وَمَكَرُوا وَمَكَرَ اللَّهُ وَاللَّهُ خَيْرُ الْمَاكِرِينَ They plan and Allah plans, and Allah is the best of the planners. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows it to people sometimes. people, if people still don't open their eyes and try to think and reflect as to what's happening, it's their fault. Especially believers, people of Iman, when they do it, like it's even darkness upon darkness. There are people who don't believe that. I mean, who can? We can't even, may Allah give them tawfiq. But when people believe, they do it, and it's like Allahu Akbar. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent this book that we have been given, the Quran, as a guidance, as a nur, as a light for all of us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put some stories in the Quran just to show us, you know, that this was the sunnah, these were the processes that I developed. But then sometimes I change these processes to just let you know that, you know, don't look at the processes, look at who has created those processes. These are just as for your help, for your guideline. If there was no gravitational force, for example, people would have been flying in the air, right? It would have been an issue for them. So all of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created is for our benefit, for me and you, every single thing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that all this air and this water and this everything I have created for you so that you conquer it and use it for your benefit. So these are just for our benefit, but then we shouldn't just be looking at what's out there, what's around us, this wall and these shelves and these sofas and whatever. We shouldn't be looking at just that. We shouldn't be looking at what's behind that. This is what our job is as the believers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right? So when I was saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent stories in the Quran, just look into a few stories. For example, say that Ibrahim alayhi salam. We all know, right? Ibrahim alayhi salam, when the king, he decided to put him into the fire, right? When he was about to be thrown into the fire, what does the fire do normally? The fire normally burns. But then, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that, Ya naru kuni barran wa salaman ala Ibrahim. That, O fire, you become cold and of peace to Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. And it became like that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed, you know, although the process is fire burns, but, you know, there is somebody who is planning, who has created that fire, and it's his decision if you want to change the process for some time, right? So our side should not be at the means. Our side should be at the who created the means, who created the processes. This is what our job is as believers, and this is the test. All this 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80 years of life that we all have been given, the job is that we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and believe it with our heart. Every time that something happens, we should always look back at Allah. This is all what life is about. This test that we have been given, this is all what it's about. Every single moment in our lives. Even if you're sitting here listening, talking, you know, there's a reason behind that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hasn't told all of these stories in the Quran for our like enjoyment. He hasn't done that. There's a reason behind that. Right? The reason is that you look into it, you believe in it. ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. That this is a book which is no doubt, absolutely. The first ayah in the Quran after Fatiha. You're going to read this book? No, it has no doubt. Absolutely no doubt. هُدَلْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. But this is a guidance for the people who actually have that taqwa in the heart. The people of Iman, people of belief, this is a guidance for those people. So when you read all of these stories, get something out of that. And that is the reason also that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you look into the stories of the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sometimes mentions, like a bigger story, the end first, and then the middle part somewhere else, and then the beginning at the end. Because the idea is not to tell us stories. Idea is that the lessons learned from all of these stories, right? Looks like it's a big project management, right? Change of processes, right? Lessons learned. This is all what's happening. Look into this, read this, see what happened. Same will happen to you. Read this, what happened. Exam, this will happen to you if you do this a similar thing. All of these are lessons learned from what happened in the past. There's no doubt about that, absolutely. This is what our test is about. This is what Quran, Huda, guidance. Look into all of that, read that, and get guidance from it. If you don't want to get guidance, you still say you believe, it's your problem. And don't come back and complain, you know, this happened and that happened, you know, you didn't do what you were supposed to do. Right? So, a non-believer, he always lives on like possibilities. You know, what if this happens? And he is trying to make his own decisions. Like, for example, a patient comes into an emergency room, right? The first thing that the doctor in the emergency room does is, you know, this may happen. This, you know, he is having all of these signs, so there are possibilities of this, and this. You know, this is the first report that he comes out with. And then they do all the tests, their blood tests, and urine, and stool, and this, and that, and blah, 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 x-rays, whatever needed. And then at the end of the day, maybe after a few hours, they can, you know, oh, by the way, out of all of these possibilities, this was the exact thing that actually happened to this person. So a non-believer, he's just looking at the possibilities. But a believer, he knows exactly, 100%, that what happened. He knows exactly, 100%, what happened because of his belief. Because all of the signs and the reports have already been created. All what we have to do is, you know, when something happens, look into, oh, this, no, this didn't happen, this should happen. Ah, this happened. This was the root cause for that. So we know exactly, this is what the belief is all about. And this is the test, right? So these asbab, the processes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created, you know, as I said, these are just the processes. And the beauty is that Allah, we have to look at as to who created these processes, right? And anything can come out of that process as a result, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is planning all the things, right? Sometimes what happens is that He takes, for example, there is a process that if somebody is going through this, then as the end result, he will be honored. Right? So this is the process of being honored. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sometimes out of that process takes our disgrace. Right? For example, Qarun. Qarun had everything that people think that they need in order to get honored in this dunya. Right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and he used to say he got all of these treasures. He said, "Utitahu ala ilmin indi," that I have got because of my knowledge. You know, I'm a very smart person. I've used all of this and that into my business. You know, definitely all the profit that I'm getting is because of my knowledge. This is what Qarun did. Right? Oh, I'm a very smart person. All the good grades that I get in my college is because of my intellect and the smartness that I have. Oh, I've got into this managerial post, right? You know, this is because of what a smart person am I. Right? This is what Qarun said. Utitahu ala ilmin indi. Ah, mashallah, I'm doing so great in my business. It's because of what am I. This is what people do. This is what Qarun did. Right? He had everything. And people used to envy him. When he used to come out with all his treasures and like all the keys, and people, فَخَرَجَ عَلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ فِي زِينَتِهِ, he used to come out to his nation with all of what he had, right? And people used to say, يَا لَيْتَ لَنَا مِثْلَ مَا أُوتِيَ قَارُونَ, oh, we wish that we can also get what Qarun got. Right? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, oh, you feel that he is a very respected, honorable person. You know, you feel that he is saying he's got all of this out of his intellect, you know. Alright, let me tell him what he is, all the arrogance and pride that he has in his heart, that he is feeling that he has done all of that by himself, all what he's got is because of his own intellect. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala drowned him in the earth. فَخَسَفْنَا بِهِ وَبِدَارِهِ الْأَرْضِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, we drowned him and his treasures in the ground. Now all of these people, say now they're saying, ah, thank God, we didn't do that. Right? There were people who were investing all of this in the banks, getting all of this interest money out of that, you know, 5%, 6%, blah, 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 you know. You go and tell them, you know, it's not right, it's not interest. They come and argue and all of that. And suddenly all the banks got bankrupted, and then the people who did believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and knew that the interest money is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, that this is like a fight with Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know, when they saw all of that happening, now they saw the Qarun and his treasure being drowned in the earth, now they're seeing it, now they're happy. But now they're happy because they believed in what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had told them. Right? This is the test. Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam, subhanAllah, look at what happened in his life. He's a child, the brothers got jealous of him, he's taken into the thought of the plan to kill him, to put him into a well. Now think about it, a person, a small little child, 10, 11 years old, he's thrown into the well. Can somebody even think where he's going to end? No. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took him out, Allah's plans, Allahu Akbar, took him to the palace of the king, and king made him a son, right? And now another test happened. The wife of the king, she seduced him and asked him to have relations with her, and he refused, right? And she put him into jail. Another thing, can somebody think that somebody in the jail can go somewhere else? Allahu Akbar. Looks like the processes are of something of disgrace, dishonoring. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him to some place, and everybody, even his parents and his brothers, are coming and doing sajda to him, sajda of honor. That were allowed in that time. Allahu Akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows in the Quran, ذَٰلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ, no doubt in this book, that you know what? Don't look at what you feel might give you benefit or might give you harm. Don't look into that. Look into that, what will happen if you do this thing. And even if you do something and you feel that this will be the result that may come out of it, still don't be 100% sure of that. Still keep making dua and ask Allah, oh Allah, please give me khair out of that. I have taken all the things that you have asked me to do. I'm not disobeying you. You have asked me to do A, B, C, D, and F. I'm doing all of that. Still, I'm afraid, I'm fearful in my heart, oh Allah, that I don't know what will be my end result. I'm still fearful, oh Allah. So I ask you, oh Allah, because you are the Musabbab al-Asbab. You are the one who owns all of these processes and the results out of these processes. I ask you, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you give me khair out of this. This is what a believer is like. This is what a believer is like. This is what we all need to do. Never look into our own selves. Never, like, try to be smart. Yes, you have to do whatever you can do, but then have your eyes at Allah. This is the true belief is. This is what قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ means. Right? So we have to know that whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us in His Sharia, that's all where the good lies. And anything that's against the Sharia, that's all where the bad lies. And this is our test. Although we may feel that doing things A, B, and C might give us something that's might be harmful, but we have to have 100% belief that that will not be harmful if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that there will be good out of that. For example, giving in charity looks like your treasure is going, your wealth is going to decrease, but it doesn't happen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that you give one, I'll give you 10, or up till 700 or more. يُضَاعَفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ, He increases to whatever He wishes, right? you take interest money, looks like you're getting more. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَمْحَقُ اللَّهُ الرِّبَى وَيُرْبِي الصَّدَقَاتِ. Allah destroys, vanishes interest. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we have to believe in every single hukam of Sharia that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even showed it to his prophets to build that yaqeen in their heart. See, the Musa alayhi salam going with his wife, right? In the middle of the night, saw a fire. It was cold. His wife was expecting. And he said, you know, to take care of his family, he said, you know, he saw a fire. So let me go and grab some fire from there, that place, so that you can feel the warmth of that and maybe feel a little better because of all the cold that's here. Right? He went out and then that was a sign from Allah. So, oh, what you're looking at, I'm Allah, I want to talk to you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him, مَا تِلْكَ بِيَمِينِكَ يَا مُوسَى. What is in your hand, يَا مُوسَى? Right? He said, هِيَا عَصَايَ. You know, Allah, this is my stick. And he wanted to talk more to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. You know, there was a chance to talk to somebody. He just increased in this conversation. Just didn't say it's my, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just asked him, what's in your hand? He said, it's my stick. Right, and when now the love that he had for Allah in his heart, he has got a chance to talk to his beloved, he started talking more. He said that أَتَوَكَّهُ عَلَيْهَا. You know, I take support from this. I said, وَأَهُشُّ بِهَا عَلَىٰ غَنَمِي. I herd my cattle with this. وَلِيَ فِيهَا مَآرِبُ أُخْرَىٰ. Oh Allah, I get all of these benefits from this. No, he's not, he feels that, you know, the stick that's in my hand, it's a very beneficial thing. Oh Allah, I do this and that and that and that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, okay, you know, let me increase your yaqeen a little bit more. You feel that all the benefits in your stick. He said, Alqiha ya Musa. Oh Musa, throw it. And as soon as he threw it, he said, Falqaha fa'idha hiya hayyatun tasa. Allahu Akbar. As soon as he threw it, it became a snake, running snake. And Musa alayhi salam got fearful. Ah, I was thinking it's very beneficial. Now it's a snake. It's very harmful. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now, of course he knew the hearts. He says, خُذْهَا وَلَا تَخَفْ. Take it, hold it, don't be afraid. Now he is like, he's thinking, you know, it's a snake, how can I hold it? It's going to bite me. But as soon as, of course, order of Allah, he held it, you know. سَنُعِيدُهَا سِيرَتَهَا الْأُولَىٰ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I change him to the same seerah, not the surah, not only that it changed back to stick. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I even changed the seerah, the qualities of that, back to that of a stick. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to show Musa alayhi salam. Then you know, you felt it's beneficial, I can make a beneficial thing into a harmful thing. And now you felt it was a harmful thing, I can change a harmful thing into a beneficial thing. This is what it's all about. It's Allah who is in control of every single thing in this life. Whatever we do, every single moment of our lives, there is a planner that's behind that. We are all worried and we are all thinking and planning and plotting 100% of time. We are sleeping and we are getting dreams of, you know, well, how am I going to tackle this and that and this and that. Sleep to Allah. Do whatever you can do to follow the Sharia, the Ahkam, the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Leave it to Allah. Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel. You know, I put my trust in Allah and He is the best of my supporter or my friend or my helper. Ni'mal Mawla wa ni'mal Nasir. This is what our test is about. At the day of Badr, there were 70 odd believers, and they looked into the army coming from the other side. Everybody was like wearing the iron sheets and all of that, right? They had all these ammunition, so-called, quote-unquote, right? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala quoted like what was in their hearts. Sahaba were afraid. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كَأَنَّهَا يُسَاقُونَ إِلَى الْمَوْتِ وَهُمْ يَنْظُرُونَ. He said that they felt as they are pushed into the death, and they are looking. They're looking, you know, they're being pushed into the death, into the mouth of death. They were afraid, they were like, and Allah, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asking dua all night, O Allah, and beautiful dua, look into the books, then O Allah, if all these small little group of believers, O Allah, if they go away, then who will be there to take your name, O Allah, please help us. Right now the Prophet ﷺ has that yaqeen, it's only, still, even we are 70, they are like 1,000, whatever, right? Sorry, there were 313, and there were like 1,000 non-believers on the other side. So even we are 300 odd, and these are so many, you know, but this was Prophet of Allah, he knew. You know, kam min fi'atin qaleelatin ghalabat fi'atin kathiratan bi'idhnillah. How many times Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, how many times that a small group of people dominated a big group of animals, bi'iznillah, with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he knew this in his heart, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, so it doesn't matter, what all I need to do is I have to do what I can do, prepare whatever with sticks, right, the stems of the trees, as compared to the swords, the shining swords. And then he asked Allah, O Allah, you are the helper. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent out Jibreel al-Islam with his army. The whole picture changed. This is what a believer is all about. Do whatever you can do according to Sharia, and then leave everything to Allah. Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel. لِيُحِقَّ الْحَقَّ وَيُبْتَلَ الْبَاطِلِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I wanted the truth to prevail so that I can show that this is the truth and this is the falsehood. Right? Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam going with his ashab, the whole nation. Fir'aun is behind them, suddenly there's the river in front of them. Allahu Akbar. There's an army behind, a big army, and now they're just going, they're chasing them, and suddenly they got at the bank of the river. So there is death in front, there is death in the back. And people with their weak, the people who had that shakiness in their heart, that's what they said. Right? قَالَ أَصْحَابُ مُوسَى إِنَّا لَمُدْرَكُونَ. The Sahaba of Musa alayhi salam said, you know, Musa alayhi salam, we are drowned, they're gone. Musa alayhi salam said, no. Inna ma'ya rabbi sayahdi. You know, I have my Lord with me, he will surely guide me. He knew, you know, this is all, you feel, you know, this is all what's happening. But what all I have done is at the order of my Lord, he will definitely help me. How is it possible that I am asking Allah for his support, I've done exactly what was asked of me, and now he's going to misguide me, he's going to drown me? No. This was the yaqeen. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Adrib bi asaq al-bahr." Musa al-Islam, throw your stick on the sea. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created ways, paths in that sea, and they all crossed. Allahu Akbar. This is belief. Quran, Azim al-Shan. This is what our job is, to keep reminding each other and keep reminding ourselves. We all plan and plot all our day long and we are busy doing 100,000 things, but what we forget is Allah. Anytime something happens, you know, we are crying and screaming and shouting, you know, this happened and that happened, we always forget Allah. If we have done things according to the orders of Allah, know that Allah will protect you. If you have done things according to the orders of Allah, know that Allah will protect you. Know that if you have done things according to the orders of Allah, Allah will protect you. But if people leave the Sharia, leave the orders of Allah, then know that there is no help from Allah. People still like, they keep on doing what they feel like again, right? I have got all of this according to my intellect, I am smart. People don't follow the sunnahs of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and still are waiting for that barakah to come down on them. How is it possible? قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. And if you claim that you say that you love Allah, you believe in Allah, then follow the Messenger of Allah. And Allah will love you and forgive you of your sins. Allah will send down the mercy and the rahmah and the barakah of all what you are looking for in your life. But then people still do what they do, and then when things go wrong, and who are they complaining about? They're complaining about their own selves. Right? قل اللهم مالك الملك تؤتي الملك من تشاء. It's Allah who is the Lord of all the dominions. He gives His dominion to whoever He wishes. وتنزع الملك ممن تشاء. He takes away the dominion from whoever He wishes. وتعز من تشاء وتذل من تشاء. He is the one who gives honor to whoever He wishes. And He is the one who disgraces whoever He wishes. Right? He is the one تولج الليل في النهار وتولج النهار في الليل. He is the one taking out day from the night and night from the day. Right? وتخرج الحي من الميت وتخرج الميت من الحي. He is the one who takes life from the death and death from the life. وترزق من تشاء بغير حساب. He is the one who gives risk to whoever He wishes without any hisab, without any reckoning, right? And still people get, some people becomes like a millionaire or billionaire, and there are other people who are trying to pull his leg, and how can I disgrace him, and all of that, having jealousy and all of that in their hearts, that, well, it's Allah's risk, He has given him. You will get whatever is in your fate. Why are we jealous about that person? All the diseases of the heart are because of that lack of iman in the hearts of the people. And somebody got promoted and everybody is like getting jealous of him. Why are you doing that? You will get your fate. You do what you are supposed to do. People get sick and then they're complaining, and you know, they're going to this amil, and you know, somebody has done magic on him. You know, my puppo and my khala, they are jealous, they must have done my magic. They're getting their nails and their waters and this and that and all of that. Allahu Akbar. وَإِذَا مَرَدْتُ فَهُوَ يَشْفِينَ. When I get sick, then He is the one who gives me cure. Where is that belief? Why are you running, all of us running to the amils right away? Why didn't we run to Allah? Why didn't we just raise our hands in the middle of the night and cried in front of Allah and asked for cure? وَالَّذِي هُوَ يُطْعِمُنِي وَيَسْقِينِ. He is the one who gives food, He is the who gives drink. وَالَّذِي يُمِيتُنِي ثُمَّ يُحْجِينِ. He is the one who gives life, He is the one who gives death. وَالَّذِي أَطْعَمُ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ لِي خَطِيئَةِ يَوْمَ الدِّينِ. I hope that He will forgive my son's sins on the Day of Judgment. I have all my hope in Allah. People, some people like get married. Sometimes people are not getting married, and then again they are going to all of the somebody must have done magic, as if these magicians have the power over Allah. Come on, you ask Allah for your fate, for a good spouse, you will get what you are looking for. When people get married, then they're not getting children. Somebody must have done magic on me. People are only getting daughters, not getting sons, ah, people must have done magic on me, as if it's getting daughter is something that's disgraceful. Are you a believer or people from the Jahiliyyah who used to feel that daughters are disgraceful, getting daughters is disgraceful, and they used to bury them in the ground? What are you? Say, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. And Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had four, didn't have a son. What an honor to have daughters. People still alive. Somebody must have done magic on me. Lillahi mulku samawati wal ard. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has all the dominion of the heaven and the earth. Yakhluqu ma yasha. He created whatever He wishes. Yahu liman yasha'u inasa. He gives daughters to whoever He wishes. Wa yahu liman yasha'u dhukur. He gives sons to whoever He wishes. أَوْ يُزَوِّجُهُمْ ذُكْرَانًا وَإِنَاسًا. He gives daughters and sons to whoever mixes them. وَيَجْعَلُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ أَقِيمًا. He made a few women barren. Don't get a child. So what? It's Allah's decision. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is stating that in the Quran. It's me who is giving you all of that. And you're still running after these amils and these magicians are in controlling of, you'll get daughter and you'll get son. Allahu Akbar, a'udhu billah. People not getting promotion, let me get that amil, read something, blow on me, blah blah blah. As if he is controlling the honor and your promotions and your marriages and your children and all of that. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عِنْدَهُ إِلْمُ السَّاعَةِ. It's in the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when the hour will come. وَيُنَزِّلُ الْغَيْثِ. And He is in the knowledge of Allah then when the rain will fall. And we have so much belief in, looking at the weather channel every single morning, and going out with their umbrellas, it's going to rain heavily today. That's what they were saying in the last 3 days, right? Not even a drop fall down, I think. That's the reason that we have been asked, and whenever you talk about the future, you say, inshallah, if Allah wishes, then this will happen. And we have so much belief in these weather channels as if that will definitely happen, without even thinking in the back of our mind, inshallah. وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي الْأَرْحَامِ. He knows what's in the wombs. وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ مَا تَكْسِبُ غَدًا. Nobody knows what's going to earn tomorrow. Nobody knows. You make all of these plans, I'm going to go into the stock market tomorrow, and I'm going to sell this stock at blah blah price, and I'm going to get this much profit. You don't even know if you're going to live by tomorrow. وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ بِأَيِّ أَرْضٍ تَمُوتُ. Nobody knows which earth he's going to die. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ خَبِيرٌ. Everything is in the knowledge of Allah. He is the knowledgeable. He is the knower. So this is what our belief should be. If we still do not follow the Sharia, we still do not follow what Allah has given us, and wrong things happen, and we still try to make our own plannings and own plotting, and feel that something will come out of it. We shouldn't complain then. We still are doing the same old things. We are still going to the internet and watching all the rubbish that we watch. And we assume Allah's blessing and mercy is going to fall. We still have mixed gatherings and don't even know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created a hijab between men and women. And we assume that Allah's blessings will fall. We know that, watching and looking at our TV screens, all the rubbish that we watch, and we believe that Allah's blessings will fall. SubhanAllah, strange statement. I talked to a few people, I let my children sleep before I watch TV because these are the things that the children shouldn't be watching. Why should you be watching this? Did Allah allow you to watch that and not your children? How will the blessings fall? People still cheat and lie and deceive and hurt people. and think bad about other people and are jealous of other people and complaining about other people and backbiting and fighting and arguing and all of this, and then they assume that the blessings will fall. How will the blessings fall? We should be believers. Become believers. Ya ayyuhal ladheena amanu, aminu billahi wa rasulihi. Oh, you who believe in Allah and His Messenger. Allah is talking to the believers. Oh, you who believe in Allah and His Messenger. Where are you going? What are you doing? You're supposed to do something. You're doing something else. Open your eyes. Everything that something happens, we should ask Allah. Somebody not getting married, ask Allah and then be content with his decision. Somebody not getting children, ask Allah and be content with his decision. Somebody not getting sons and daughters or children or whatever, ask Allah and be content with his decision. People divorce their wives that they have only given them daughters and not sons. Allahu Akbar, it was you who was responsible, not your wife. If there was anybody responsible, even he wasn't responsible. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's decision. But if there was any sabab for that, it was the man. He should have been divorced. People beat their wives. Allahu Akbar. So strange. You look into all of that. You get all of these fitnas and all of that. No. Fitna of today, the biggest fitna, you know, this opposite gender relationship. The girls talking, emailing to boys doing the same thing, and then at the end of the day there is something wrong, there is no sakina in their life, and they're getting into troubles. Who is responsible? Where are you going to get the blessings from? Ya ayyuhal ladheena amanu, ya ayyuhal... What is that? Udkhulu fi silmi kaffa. For you who believe, enter into the deen completely. Get into complete submission, 100%. Afatu'minuna bi ba'd al-kitab wa takfuruna bi ba'd. You believe in part of the book, you don't believe in the other part of the book. You choose whatever you feel is easy on you, and then you know, I'm okay praying, but you know, I cannot do this. I cannot do hijab. Sorry. Why? That was an order of Allah. This is an order of an Allah. People watching all of these rubbish movies, right? And then expecting their wives to do the same what they watch in the movies. Allahu Akbar. What are you doing? People forget their graves. They don't even know that there's going to be a small little ditch that all are going to get into, this dark, and it's their choice that Allah has given them as a free will, that if you want to make it from the gardens of paradise, or they want to make it from the ditch of an hellfire. Waliyadu billah. People forget all of that. People forget the snakes of the ground that may come into that. People forget the day of judgment. How can they stand in front of Allah? يَوْمَ تُبْلَى السَّرَائِرِ. On that day, all the secrets will be made open. All that we have in our hearts will be made open. اِقْرَأَ الْكِتَابِ. Read your book. All what you are doing, it's written in here, every single thing. Read it. Yourself. And people will be hiding then. They don't even want, they will not even want to take that book in their hands. Anyway, so we all have to think about it before it's too late. We have to do tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala today. And we have to start a new life. That's pleasing to Allah, that's of obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then, once we do it, at least try of the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. start doing it, start taking that step, and then have hope from Allah as well. Don't be hopeless. Be hopeful. قُلْ لِعِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَصْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِن رَّحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. Tell the people who have drowned themselves in the sins, don't be hopeless, never be hopeless from Allah, from the mercy of Allah. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. He is the one who forgives every sin. Go back to Allah. Ask Him, Allah, I'm sorry for the life that I've lived. And Allah is there, ready to accept every single one of us. Take that decision. The decision is ours. Before it's too late, this is the test. This is all what it's about. This is all what life is about. Even we are doctors, engineers, project managers, students, businessmen, whatever. That's all. This is like a, you know, when we play these board games, game of or whatever, like everybody becomes a player of certain kind. This is what we are. If somebody is a doctor, engineer, or laborer, or whatever, this is what we are, playing a board game. Everybody has a job to play and to do. But the goal, everybody's goal is the same. If there is a laborer who is working to build these tall buildings out there, you know, Al-Kasibu Habibullah. The people who do the work with their hands, Allah, Prophet ﷺ saying they are the Habibullah, they are friends of Allah, they are the beloved of Allah. And then similarly, if there is a businessman, a tajir, who is doing all his business with honesty according to the Sharia, he will be raised on the Day of Judgment in ma'an nabiyyin wa siddiqeen wa shuhada. It's not about who you are in this dunya. It's all about how you live your life. Whatever is in your fate, whatever Allah has given you, if you play that part according to the Sharia that's given to all of us, that's what the life is about. We have to change our hearts. We have to mold our hearts. We should become the people of Allah. Inna awliya Allahi la khawfun alayhim wa lahum yahzanun. We should try to become the friends of Allah. And there will be no fear and no grief for these people. But these are the people. Who are these people? These are the people who have taqwa in their hearts. And we should show taqwa in every single thing that we do. Be it our relationship in our homes with our families, or be it something that's outside our homes. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq that we be able to understand all of this, and we be able to act. We be able to know what is required of us, and then we be able to act on it, and so that we live a life that's pleasing to Allah, and we be able to change this dirty soul into something that's nafsul mutma'inna, so that when it's time to go back to Allah, the angels will come and ask, and they'll call, Ya ayyatuhan nafsul mutma'inna, irji'i ila rabbiki. That, oh nafsul mutma'inna, who have worked on your souls and who have purified your hearts, come to your Lord, radiyatan mutma'innatan, in a state that Allah is pleased with you, and you are in state of itminan, peace. Fadkhuli fi ibadi, enter into my slavehood. Wadkhuli jannati, enter into my paradise. This is what will be called at the time of the death, if people work on their own selves, on their hearts, and change their life according to what's pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa akhru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.